Hey everyone, I hope you're doing well. Thanks for joining me. And there's a couple of things I'm going to talk about in this video. There's going to be some channel updates, some shout outs, and then the topic of the video, acts of kindness. But for those of you wondering why I'm recording from within my car, I've done some of these before. It's been about a year. And that's why I've called this Bare Bones ASMR, because you don't always need an elaborate production to make videos, or fancy equipment, or all microphones and cameras and all that stuff. Just record, whether you're making ASMR videos or not. If you have something that you need to express and you feel have a strong desire to do that, you don't need fancy equipment. And that's kind of one of the reasons why I'm here and why I do this channel, is for me just being myself and to promote that to others. You know, that you don't always need fancy equipment. You know, just do your thing. And, you know, the reason that I make some of the videos that I do with a little bit higher production values, that's just something personal that I like. I love film, and so I just try to emulate that in the videos that I make. And that's all. I'm not here to show off. I'm not here to gain all the likes. I'm not here to please everyone, to be popular, to be famous, none of that. If I was, I wouldn't fucking do a video like this, and I wouldn't swear. So, acts of kindness is going to be kind of all throughout the nature of this video, and that is why I want to do some shout-outs. Shout-outs to mostly some other ASMR content creators, whether we're friends or not, we're somewhat acquainted at least. So I've never really done this too much, you know, I feel good and I want to create a little positive vibe and make a little positive chain reaction here. Some of you may know some of these folks, some of you may not. So here we go. Tony Tingles, Smiling Observer, of course, Urara 1966, Derek Michael, No Stars in the Perimeter, Tarar, and I don't know how to pronounce the other half of your channel name, forgive me, I'll call you Dr. Andrews, ASMR Nova Star, I hope you're doing well, especially, Peaceful Mind ASMR, Indigo Stars, happy birthday, and happy birthday to anyone else that is recently celebrating a birthday or is going to be in the coming days. Fat Free Pudding, Tabuhan ASMR, from Turkey, I believe. Tabuhan, I'm not sure how you pronounce that. Northern Whispers, or Northern, y'all know him for the most part, I believe. A lot of you, Angels Whispering ASMR, she's fairly new. Hushed Life ASMR. Yapshire, even though he doesn't make as much videos anymore, still it was a big part at one point in time, and you know, in my channel or influence. Harley, I don't know your channel name. I should know it. That's but y'all know Harley, right? Whimsy Whispering. Hey, who's the other angel? Oh my god, this is terrible. ASMR Angel, right? With the Biscuits of Britain. And yeah, if I missed anyone, it wasn't really intentional. I just, I was going to do this vlog on acts of kindness, and then next thing I know, I have this, this whole page. Sorry there. That I have this whole page written out, and I just want to give a shout out to some folks, and do that. And of course, all viewers and my subscribers and patrons, of course, I really appreciate it. This is just really the beginning. I know I've been on this YouTube channel for like 3 years. This is really just the beginning. I haven't even felt like I'm still like I'm starting to really get to where I want to go, and I don't even know where that is. But you know, I try when I wake up every morning. I don't really have any goals, except to try to see what I can create. You know, I wake up and try to be the best that I can each day. You know, get our son, my wife and I, have our routine, get our son ready for school, see him for half an hour in the morning, thank you capitalism, and then we go to work, and then we come home, and we see our son for 2 hours, and before he goes to bed, again, thank you capitalism, and you know, so it's family first, and then I create afterwards. But you know, I stumble and I make mistakes, and I say and do things that I regret. Sometimes sometimes what I say and what I do gets cheers, and sometimes I get jeers. But at the end of the day, and at the end of my life, I hope that the big picture overall will be a positive one. And the positive actions and words and things that I do in life will outweigh the bad. And that's all any of us can do. You know, we're all going to make mistakes. We're all going to say things, get in fights, quarrels, bicker. You know, have accidents, get in a car accident, hurt someone by accident, things like that. But as long as your intent each day is to have a positive impact and to not willfully go out and be a mean-spirited person, you know, that's what really matters, you know. So, updates, channel updates. After this video is going to be a Minecraft video, not Minecraft, well, a Minecraft video, but the Minecraft. I'm going to be continuing building the castle of our mind, so that will be uploaded the day after this one. I'm going to be revisiting old series like The Curious Case of the Couch Companion, The Peculiar Plastic Pouch Predicament, Arkham Lost and Found. Margaret is going to open up her salon, and she'll be doing your makeup. Look for that. The Joker video hasn't been forgotten. I just had to get into the mood of that. I got to put green paint in my hair. I can't dye my hair green because I have to go to work, and I kind of need my work, my job, to pay my bills and support my family. But I'm going to try to do something with the green body paint that I have. I also bought red lipstick for that as well. But I just have to get into the mindset for that. Phantom of the Opera. I still want to do Phantom of the Opera. I haven't forgotten about that. Again, it's I'm very day-to-day. I don't do schedules. I'm very improv, just be in the moment. The Colonist as well. I actually want to have the Candyman visit the visit the viewer who was actually impregnated or has become a host to the alien. So before the alien bursts through their chest, I want the Candyman to show up and be like, "Hey, I heard you know, that you're not feeling so well. I brought you some candy." And then, "Well, what's that at the end?" or something like that. So that's podcasts. I have plans to do the Letters from the Apocalypse, as well as a bedtime story and the Lovecraft readings. Now I want to turn the Lovecraft readings so that I can make the audio like audiobooks. I kind of want to do it in the audiobook format. So I may restart the whole Lovecraft thing. The problem is there's so many things that I want to do. As my good friend or acquaintance, Smiling Observer, recently said somewhere, if he had $10 million, he'd be able to watch every video and do what he wanted to. Same here. I mean, there's a lot of things I want to do, but I'm limited between family, job, and maintaining a healthy sleep schedule, lifestyle. So that is all for the updates. So we're going to talk about this acts of kindness, and I'm just looking here to make sure I haven't forgotten anything. Kind of going off from that I love you video where I was chasing you down in the woods, chasing the viewer down in the woods, was just this weird spur of the moment thing I just wanted to do during my lunch hour at work, believe it or not. I kind of said this in my latest podcast too, on the FM radio show. Again, a huge thanks to Patriot King, who just on a whim pretty much suggested the name FM radio, and I think it's just perfect. It's funny. So thanks. Acts of kindness, you know, we don't have to say I love you verbally to show love. You can do it through simple acts of kindness, and it could be simple as, you know, saying hello to someone with a smile. Or it could be holding a door for someone, helping someone that's fallen up, helping someone that has fallen up. That happens a lot, gravity. Sometimes people just fall up and you have to pull them down. Someone that's fallen down. I've done that, there's actually been like two occasions in my life for some real weird reason. The only two instances of someone that is, for the most part, that I can remember. You know how we do a lot of things in our lives, and for some reason, some of these certain memories just stand out. And I remember, like, back in the 90s, I was living in the city, there was an elderly man, I was walking home from work, and this elderly man, it was raining out, and he slipped on the pavement or something, and he fell down, and I just happened to be there to help him up. Not a big deal, you know, but I helped him up. You know, it's what you do. Well, then last year we were at a little place, some of you may know, it's called Linvilla Orchards. They have pumpkins and they have all this stuff there. And there's an elderly man, I didn't see him fall, but I was outside and he was laying down and there's a crowd of people and there's a whole bunch of people just standing around watching this guy. He was falling and he had someone with him, and the person that was with him was kind of like in the middle of like, hey, are you okay? Can you get up and all this? And they weren't actually pulling him up yet. And my wife there, my son was there, and I just felt this, you know, just compelled to just and help him up and help the old guy up. And, you know, not a big deal. Wasn't trying to look at me. I said, hey, you're welcome. And we walked off. And no, I'm not looking for applause or anything like that. And, you know, it's simple things like that, that it's not, you know, is that person going to remember? Maybe so. You know, that's the whole point. We have, and I want to get to the other act of kindness that happened last night, which is why I'm here. But, you know, there are acts of kindness where, that you don't know the impact. There's so much negativity we deal with in the world. And I'm like an antenna. I mean, good, bad, whatever stimuli is out there, yeah, I receive it. You know, part of being a highly sensitive person, and those of you new to that term, it just simply means that there are a certain percentage of people that have a very sensitive nervous system. That means they are sensitive to things they see, hear, taste, and smell. It doesn't mean it's a superpower. It just means some of us are very, just take everything in and feel things a lot more deeply, quite empathetic, and we just notice everything. And so we can tune in onto the nuances and subtleties of life. And so, man, I just sidetracked myself. So yeah, I'm an antenna, and I just, someone recently said that about Bill Hicks. Bill Hicks was like an antenna. And anyway, I'm not trying to compare myself to the great Bill Hicks at all, but I've just that I can that resonates with me. So anyway, I'm getting sidetracked of what the heck I was just saying before that antenna thing, but the whole point is, that these acts of kindness, you don't know. Oh yeah, the negativity. So I neg it's really easy. There's so much negativity in the world. It's very easy to focus on that, and we know, because we that's what we see. Well, it's the news focuses on it, a lot of it, because it's ratings, it's drama, and that's what the news is all about, to make money. They don't really want to make the world a better place. They just want to ratings, all that nonsense, which is why I don't watch the news, because it's negative. I was sitting in the doctor's office about a week or so ago, and there was a TV, which I don't ever watch except for The Walking Dead. TV was on, and it was like crime, violence, someone broke out of jail, someone got stabbed, this or that, and then it was a little bit about the weather, more crime and violence, something about music, and then a nice little, "Okay guys, enjoy your day," by the hosts. "Oh yeah, you just, oh yeah, I'm ready to really enjoy my day now. You just told me how violent and the world is and all this." So I'm very susceptible to negativity, and when I pick up on things, I pick up on people's, I pick up on everything. I mean, it's hard to get something by me. Sometimes I can be naive. And sometimes I try to be naive because I don't want to focus on all the things that negatively can influence me. So we have a choice every day, I mean every moment, to from love and fear. As Bill Hicks said, other people say that. What does that mean, love and fear? Well, acts of kindness. We're living in fear and not being kind and being judgmental and being angry and mean and causing negativity. And that's really what love and fear. And I never really understood that myself until till now, recently. And I would rather, and I try my best. I'm no saint, but I try each day, as I said in the beginning of this video, I try every day to promote, to do acts of kindness. And I don't want to be a saint. I'm not looking around. I don't go out in the world, "Look at me, I'm such a kind, compassionate person." I go about my business under the radar. Well, I mean, I have a YouTube channel, but for the most part, in real life, outside of YouTube, I try to just go about my business and not, I hold the door for people. I say hi to people. I'm much more now outgoing than I used to be. I used to be very more shy, introverted, especially with all the shit that I had to deal with growing up. A lot of anger that I've had because of that. So last night, and this acts of kindness thing, I'm going to try to keep this video short, or as short compared to my other videos. So my wife and I and our son, we were riding our bikes around our little apartment complex. And that's going to change. I'll keep you updated about that. I think some good things are going to happen. I don't want to jinx anything. So last night, after we got done hanging out as a family and we were playing in a little play area, we found a set of keys on the bench there. And so, we're like, "Oh, I wonder whose keys these are. We should return them to the apartment office," but the office was closed. So we're like, "Okay, we'll hang on to them for a little bit. Maybe someone will come out looking for them. And if not, we'll go to the office, maybe put them in the Dropbox, or go to the office in the morning." But then I decided, you know what? Let's find out. In a couple minutes later, after playing with our son, I think we were playing tag or something like that, running around. I said, "You know what? Wait, does that the key, the car, the key have an alarm on it?" And we checked, and it did. It had unlock and lock. So I started to press the lock button, and I could hear a car beeping. Now we had to figure out where the car, what direction the car, the beep was coming from. We eventually found the car, was right in front of another apartment unit. And so we said, all right, let's go knocking on the doors. And this is something I never would have done before. I mean, I don't know if I would have done it 5 years ago or 10 years ago. But I've reached a, and I want to say this because I know a lot of folks out there suffer with anxiety. You're shy. You would just never go up to a stranger and talk to them for the most part. Those kind of folks. So I said, so there's a couple floors. So I said to my wife and our son, all right, you go up second floor, I'll start on the first floor. And I just went up knocking on each door. And I said, have you lost a pair of car keys? Looking the people in the eye with a pleasant smile, communicating. I mean, it took a lot to build this kind of confidence up. I never had this confidence. I mean, I've had confidence from workplace environments, people you work with, that's different, but complete random strangers going up to their house, knocking on their door, make eye contact and all that, you know, that's, and I'm not here to say, hey, I'm proud of myself. There's a whole point of this. And like I said earlier, you know, it's if you are like that, there's two points. You know, if you're like that kind of, if you're that kind of person that you can't go up to someone like that, you know, it will happen. It will take time. You have to build the confidence. You just have to do it and not think so much. So we eventually found the woman and we gave her keys and she was grateful and all this and she wanted to repay us and we're like, no, it's fine. Just, you know, and we walked away. And it's great. But I do want to say, I'm not proud, but I'm saying it feels good when you make others feel good because you're creating this positive thing. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I used to feel guilty about helping others feel good and stuff like that. I don't get off on it. I don't walk around anymore. I don't walk around. I'm not like, hey, look at me. I did the good deed. That's not the whole point of this video. I know what it means about being humble and humility and know what humility is all about. Even though here I'm on YouTube, I don't let all that get to my head. The whole point is that, you know, I could have taken those car keys, found out who her car, I could have thrown the keys, I could have been an asshole. I could have stolen the car. I mean, there's a lot of negative things I could have done, but I chose, and we could have waited the next morning and let the woman find it at the office or inform the office, but I decided, you know what? Maybe she's worried. Maybe she has to go to work tomorrow. Who knows? Let's see if we can find it. Let's see if we can address this now. And have someone, you know, and because then if we make her feel good through your acts of kindness, you know, certain acts of kindness like that, hopefully it'll resonate with her and then it'll stick with her and then she'll pay it forward. That's the whole point. That's the whole point I want to make. Not look at me. I did something great. You know, what I did was not great. I returned somebody's car keys, all right? There's a lot of people that probably would have left the keys there. There's a lot of people that would have stolen her car. You know that. And there's a lot of people out there that are like that, unfortunately. Sometimes you just have to just say, fuck it, I'm going to do this kind deed. Don't think about the repercussions. Don't think about the, you know, just work. And that's how you work through anxiety, especially if you have fear, especially if you have that kind of that holds you back from doing kind things because you're afraid of something. You're afraid of the interaction or whatever. You might, you know, who knows what you're afraid of. But when you work through that, and that's how you overcome your fear. That's how you overcome anxiety, by doing the thing that you don't want to do. I don't mean if you're afraid of heights, jump off the Empire State Building or go cliff diving, you know. But, you know, there are some times where you have to put yourself into the situation, and that's how you work through it. That's how you grow. That's how you become stronger. That's how I'm here today, doing these kind of videos in the parking lot where people probably say I'm crazy. I don't really care. You know, talking, you know, maybe they don't really care, but you know, it takes the more confidence, and the more confident, the more that you're willing to do things that you don't even know you're capable of doing, and helping others, And it's great, to go out in the real world. I know I get a lot of messages from folks that say I help them with anxiety and sleep and all that because of my videos, and I appreciate that. But out in the real world, because this doesn't take too much, it takes my time, but out in the real world, it's a little more daunting of a task to interact with someone, a stranger you don't even know. You don't know if they're a good person. You don't know if they're a bad person. Maybe she didn't treat her son too well, or her family too well, her daughter too well. Maybe she has done some things. Who am I to judge? These are the keys. Give them to her. And if she, and we all make mistakes, and if she's made some mistakes or things, maybe this act of kindness is like, hey, it's cool. We all make mistakes. She'll feel good, and maybe she'll. That's what we can do. That the whole kindness thing, it just has such a, there's just so many positive impacts when we're kind to one another. And one last thing I want to say is, with that, is that instead of war, instead of sending an army of troops to battle, we should send our comedy troops to battle. Maybe instead of resolving conflicts with violence and tanks, we should send our comedy troops out or try to outprank the other party. Whoever makes the other party laugh, they should win, and that's how the grievances should be handled. Actually, probably if we send our comedy troops out on the front lines, we would probably see how silly the situation is to begin with, and we might find a better way to resolve our grievances and our differences. So that's it. I hope you got the gist and my message here today. Be kind to one another. I try my best every day, especially with my son. I could, I have a choice to raise my son. He's going to be a part of this human race, and I want him to have a positive impact, not only for himself. I only want him to grow up to feel good about himself and confident, and I would be a good father towards him. But he's going to be a member of the society, and I have an impact on how I treat him, and my wife too. And it's important, that we all, do our best. At the end of the day, that there's more kindness than there is anger, I guess. So that's all I want to say. I want to thank you for joining me, and stay tuned for more videos. And much love, peace, and respect to you all. Take care and tingle on.